windows and street people huddling on the side of the pothole-ridden, dingy road as the driver hurls through time and space. Crash landing in the capital city of India, another planet entirely. There's no place like home. Whizzing past the March to Independence, Gandhi Memorial, toward the main bazaar. Explosions of light and kaleidoscope as fireworks shoot through the air. This is my personal welcome party. Happy Diwali, yells India. Happy Diwali, yells the cab driver, turning his head to speak directly to me, continuing pedal to the metal, one hand steering the wheel as we barely avoid sideswiping a bumbling bullet cart and we tear into the narrow streets of the bazaar. Happy Diwali, yells the hotel night manager, shoving a box of sweets in my face as I lug my backpack up and drop it before the front desk. My first prasad, food blessed by the gods, that fateful night. Milk sweets made from chana, chickpea flour, and loads of ghee, clarified butter. Flashes of travel guide warnings pass before my eyes, to accept the stranger's sweet offering or to decline gracefully. Like Alice, contemplating her next move on the chessboard, I weigh the risks. Delight, diarrhea, or drugging? Let me think, but not too much. That millisecond of standing there in the lobby of the cheap hotel at 3 a.m., wondering whether to go ahead and let life eat me alive, I opt to throw caution to the wind and shove the sugary cube down the hatch. Simultaneously scared shitless and ferociously fearless, Mother India called. I answered, and I came. I live to tell about it and to share it with you, exactly as it happened. Enjoy the ride.